The Islanders are home at the Coliseum for one last night before the Islanders head to their own homes for the holiday. The Toronto Maple Leafs are here and the opening faceoff is straight ahead. Between the Toronto Maple Leafs and the New York Islanders. Hi there and welcome to our coverage of New York Islanders hockey. So glad you're with us. I'm Deb Placey. Happy holidays, season's greetings. Hope you are set to enjoy a couple of days off. The National Hockey League will take vacation the next 2 days, so a lot of teams are playing tonight, and that includes the Rangers. They're on MF. The Islanders with one last chance to give their fans a present before the holiday break as we throw it upstairs to our guys who will call it Howie Rose and Billy Jaffe.
All right, Deb, thank you very much. And the Islanders have hit perhaps a little bit of a crossroads to their season right here. At home in particular, where they'd hoped to really make up some ground after that long stretch on the road, they've lost four straight at the Coliseum. Maybe they've become a little fragile right now, but what the Islanders need to look back on is the competitiveness with which they played and with a pretty decent level of success for the first 2 months of the season.
And their execution at times was definitely a bit better, especially on the special teams, than we've seen the last few games. It's not that the guys aren't trying. This is a great group of guys, Hal. You know that as well. They work their butts off. It's coming down to execution, and also sometimes almost have to take a step back, pull it back a little bit, play simple, play smart, shorter shifts, do the little things that help make you a better hockey player. Sometimes, you know, you get yourself extended out there on the ice. What happens? Well, you miss a hit, or you miss a pass, or you miss getting the puck out, or miss getting it in, and therefore it leads to poor execution.
Well, one thing the Islanders have not done consistently, really for the last month, is put the puck away.
Yeah, this team has not been able, and that goes back to execution. It goes back to not making good decisions with the puck. And, you know, they have run into some good goalies, but when it's all said and done, play tougher, keep shooting the puck on net. Hopefully soon they'll go in.
Richard Park delivers our Geico quote book about the state of mind.
Yeah, you know, we're just trying to find the right balance right now. You know, when things don't go well, you don't want to hit rock bottom in terms of your attitude and the mood in the dressing room. But at the same time, you do want to try and identify what's not going right and obviously improve on that.
You know, whenever you're slumping as a team or an individual, it seems like one of those greasy goals kind of gets you out of that. And I think that's what we need. Be around the net and, you know, get some rebound goals, maybe one off the skate or something, get things going.
Well, maybe the Islanders use the Leafs as an example. They've turned things around after a slow start. Phil Kessel's a big reason why.
Well, because he's got scary speed. He's got the kind of speed that pushes you back, that makes a difference, that earns the respect of the defenders and netminders there. Now, the last few games, Phil Kessel has not produced a point. He still has some shots on goal. He'll always keep shooting the puck. But on the other hand, as you take a look at the most goals since November 3rd, the fact is he hasn't played well because he hasn't been feeling great. It's not a sickness or anything like that. He just doesn't have the energy. Ron Wilson, we talked to him before the game. His head coach said, you know, he's played an awful lot of hockey in a short period of time. Maybe that's affected him.
Well, another guy who had a medical issue recently is the Leafs goaltender tonight, Jonas Gustafsson, but he's fine, playing well. And the opening faceoff at the Coliseum is next.
The Islanders a bit more serious than usual this morning as they look to entertain their fans tonight. I'm sure they will enjoy their holiday break a lot more if they can leave here tonight with a win. Time now for our Emblem Health Injury Report. Emblem Health, the plan that works. Doug Waite was hoping to be back playing by Christmas, but there still isn't a timetable for his return. The original injury was 4 to 6 weeks, but it's now been almost 7. He continues to skate while it heals. Our goaltending matchup looks like this. Vesa Toskala and Jonas Gustafsson have split starts almost equally, but the monster gets the start tonight. Dwayne Rolison, who made 58 saves the first time he faced Toronto in a game the Islanders won 4-3, will go tonight. So that's your goaltending matchup as we go upstairs.
All right, thanks very much, Deb. And you look at Mark Streit there, and he's an example of a guy who has been called on to provide offense from his defense position in the past. He's gone 18 games now without a goal.
And perhaps his ice time. He's number 7 overall in the NHL, playing 25 minutes, 46 seconds a game. It's not so much about the amount of ice time, it's the type of ice time he has, Howie. Perhaps it's catching up to him a little bit. He's a phenomenal player. He's still a special type of guy. But, he might at times extend himself here and there too much, and that could lead to some mistakes.
Islanders start Park, Thompson, and Sim up front. Sim has already been yapping with Thomas Caberle of the Leafs as they get a shot right through to Rolison. And for the Islanders, Streit plays it off the glass. Sim takes the wobbly puck and misses Park with it as Caberle comes back to get it. I mentioned the wobbly puck. It was never any wobblier in this building than it was two nights ago in the game against the Tampa Bay Lightning. The ice was absolutely miserable then and was largely responsible for at least 3 of the 4 delay of game penalties.
Absolutely. Puck was bouncing all over the place. It was like a basketball game out there.
So that's something to keep an eye on tonight as Grabowski, number 84 for Toronto, plays it down low. And up the left side now comes Franz Nielsen as the Islanders change. Nice move to get in. Oposo a drive, and that hit a leg, and Karam's out of play.
Thankfully, for this guy sitting here right here, it's a lot cooler in the building tonight. The other day, it was made for Howie Rose. It was like 72 and sunny inside the Coliseum.
Yeah, that's terrible.
It was awful. It's not a hockey bit. You need a cold in here. Finally, it's cold. Hopefully, the guys, as you get a look at Kyle Oposo and his season numbers, the guys will have some good ice to move the puck with effectively, efficiently.
And those situations do go hand in hand. It was noticeably warmer in the building the other night, and the ice was notably worse than it had been. So certainly a correlation there is Mike Komisarek, number 8, from Central Islip. Throws it all the way to Rolison. Bruno Gervais winds it to the right wing side. And Blake Comeau for the Islanders lifts it ahead. This is Ian White, number 7 on defense, getting it towards the Islander line. Gervais jams it back in.
Remember that name, Ian White, folks. He will jump into the play from the back end frequently.
Islanders have it down low, but the pass missed Tavares, and Rolison's going to try and help things along. Tight exchange with Gervais. Rolison getting back in position and knocked down on the play was Ponikarovsky, and then Stajan had a shot blocked. So now it's thrown back towards the net by Lee Stempniak, number 12. Peeled off the boards but not out by Molson. All of this starting because Rolison came far out and he and Gervais were not really together on that exchange.
Well, sometimes the worst scenario is when you have that D-man coming back at the goaltender with full speed and it just gets too tight and the communication doesn't happen quickly enough and mishandoff or misplay, that type of thing happens.
Ponikarovsky spun Franz Nielsen around. Luke Shen, number 2 for Toronto, keeps it in. Now to Stajan. He tried to wrap it in front, but Jack Hillen broke it
up. Penalty coming up.
Penalty to the Leafs as Bailey carries into the Toronto zone. He's held off by Jeff Finger, and the whistle blows. The Islanders will get the first power play of the night.
And look, the Islanders are a bit lucky here. They get this break in that they get the first power play because of this play right here. See, you got a D-man skating right at the goalie. And Gervais going back deep, and he's got a man behind him as well. Rolison, though, there he'll probably look at that play and say, you know what, I got to either. I got to put it in the corner or get it behind the net. They get a look at the penalty. Stajan taking down Jack Hillen as well. A few minutes into this game, Isles go up on the power play for the first time.
So it's Tavares, Molson, and Schremp up front. Hillen and Streit on the points. Streit for the Islanders. Feeds Tavares. And John Tavares curls back. Streit to Tavares. They've got Molson in front, but Molson couldn't finish that hard pass through the crease. Hillen takes it deep. Lost it to White. And it's pounded to the line, but not out. Kept alive by Streit. And Hillen in the corner. Being checked there by Wayne Primeau, number 18. Strike keeps it in. Now for Hillen. Moves down the boards. Molson wanted that puck. He was banging the stick for it. Strike's drive is knocked aside. And Hillen to Strike, the one-timer. I don't think that got through.
And I think that hit Finger again. Finger just cross-checked Molson, lower part of the back as well there. Too many men on the ice by the Leafs. Those dark blue sweaters that they're wearing, traditional home uniforms, had 6 guys for half second on the ice there. Officials gave him the benefit of the doubt, though.
One of those blue jerseys belongs to Matt Stajan. He's in the box for tripping. 51 seconds remain on the penalty called at the 220 mark of the first period. Brons Nielsen surrounded. Stempniak failed to clear. So Strike keeps it in. He shoots. That's blocked in front. Rebound. Oposo off the post. Oposo again. And a save by Gustafsson. And Kyle Oposo's heard that sound a little too often over the last few weeks.
He gets the good shot off. Before this play, though, it's Mark Streit who is establishing the point shot on the power play. Low to high, and he gets the puck on his forehand, too. He's been receiving a lot of passes on his backhand while on the power play, and that eliminates his shot potential right there. Oposo with his shot tipped by Luke Shen as it go off the post. Presence of mind then to find the puck, how he get a second opportunity on the big goaltender, Jonas Gustafsson.
Ricard Vallin thrown out of a faceoff, so instead Stempniak takes it for Toronto against Nielsen. Islanders control. Andrew McDonald beating along the boards to Bailey. Now Nielsen out of the corner for Bailey, down low, shoots and went wide.
Confident move, though, coming off that goal line.
And McDonald fails to hold the pass.
Yeah, that's where you want to try and put that pass on the forehand. I know it's a tight quarter play, quick type of pass, but McDonald having a cut to his backhand, he uses a real long stick, Howie, for defensive purposes. That can also handcuff you at the same time like it did there on McDonald.
Now McDonald from center fires it in, and here comes Stajan out of the box. The Leafs have killed the penalty. These are the two lowest ranked penalty killing units in the NHL. The Leafs are dead last, the Islanders next to last. Phil Kessel, a shot blocked by Sutton, the rebound pushed wide by Ponikarovsky. Andy Sutton already up to his shot blocking tricks. Now it's Thompson for the Islanders. Lugging one along, McDonald a headman pass, missed Park. Batted away inside the zone by Jeff Finger, number four. Thompson after it, he put it off the side of the net. And Tomas Kaberle turns the other way. Kaberle holding on behind the Toronto goal. 5 minutes gone here in the opening period with no score. Jack Hillen winds it in. Gustafsson leaves it for Finger. We asked Ron Wilson earlier today what's the biggest reason for the recent Leaf turnaround. His answer couldn't have come any quicker or more emphatically. Goaltending. Gustafsson's been a big part of that.
Nice play in the last two games for this team. Both he and Toskala have been better as of late. Early on in the season, both were very, very bad.
Val Mayers took it towards the net. Now that drive by White is blocked.
Oh, heads up. Oh, that hit Sutton in the head. Yeah, he's all right.
Right back up. Ricard Vallin back to Kessel, and that missed the net. No, pardon me, to Jamal Mayers, number 21. No one should ever mistake Phil Kessel and Jamal Mayers. Kessel, a real goal scorer. Mayers, a real good guy. And now Beauchemin back in the Toronto zone. He may have lost Jaffe for a while. White watched by Hunter. Grabowski ties up Shrimp, taking him down. Play continues. And now Gervais throws it all the way in. Six and a half gone in the opening period. And up comes Jason Blake. Taken in by Brendan Wynn.
And good gap closure by Wynn along the board. Getting a little help from the back pressure there. He's able to cut off the winger.
Good to see you. Here comes Shrimp into the Toronto zone. Launches one off the end boards. Hunter tried to fire it in front. It hit Kaberle. And Hunter grabs it back. That might have gone out of play and then come back in onto Hunter's stick. So the whistle blows. 13:15 remaining. First period scoreless.
IOTV presents the HD highlight of the game. Get incredible HD picture and sound for free with IOTV. Keep your eye on the puck coming down. Franz Nielsen is going to rotate. He's going to rotate with Josh Bailey. Watch his quick move. No indecisiveness right there to the front. Tries to get it through. Low stick side, the far side. Bailey with a real, what I would call, confident type of play there. He hesitated for like a millisecond, Howie. He let the play develop. He saw the spot, the seam. Boom. He went after it and went towards the net.
Saw the draw deep in the Toronto zone. It is peeled back to the blue line. McDonald. Round to the corner. Grabbed by Ian White. And he lifts that one into the Islanders zone. McDonald hit by Nikolai Kuhlman. number 41.
Played very well as of late, using his big frame well, getting involved physically, getting a little more involved offensively as well. It's been the last few games where he has been one of the most noticeable lead players, Howie. That's Kuhlman.
Yeah, Ron Wilson thinks he's got the potential to be a 25-goal scorer in this league on a semi-regular basis. Hunter up for Ioensuu. That's knocked aside and then thrown in by Schremp. Karofsky laid it in behind the Islander net. Jack Hillen takes over. Sutton with a crisp first pass out of the zone, sending Nielsen in. He got locked up by Stajic. And now Oposo. And Hillen plays it into the Toronto zone, grabbed by Bailey, powers towards the slot. Looked like he might have been held there, but nothing called. Oposo's pass picked off by Kessel. And Phil Kessel chasing Andy Sutton. Sutton makes a strong turn and shovels it off the board. I don't think there's any question Andy Sutton, hands down, has been the best Islanders defenseman probably for the last month.
I would agree. His consistency level has been superior.
Blake Comeau across to Gervais. He's taking it towards the net. Now pulls up, fires one across, looking for Molson. Caroms to Comeau, and that shot missed. Missed the stick of Tavares as much as it missed anything else. Comeau out to the blue line to Witt. And Molson for Brendan Witt. Comeau let it go. Tavares for Comeau. He's stripped of the puck by Beauchemin. And Mayers couldn't get it out of the zone. Witt knocks it down. But Colton Orr has it back. This fourth line of the Leafs, Vallin, Orr, and Mayers, starts to change. And Molson back in the Islander line sends Comeau on his way. Islanders will be looking to change too. Park towards the net, backhander eaten up by Gustafsson. Comeau knocked down. And it's sent out of the zone by Nicholas Hagman, number 9.
Ron Wilson knew that Scott Gordon was going to change up lines quickly, so he did the same thing with his fourth line. Richard Park with a good speed acceleration down that left side as well. Almost made it 1-0 with a good drive up the back end.
Hrabovsky had it go off of Park. And now Sim the other way. John Sim in the Toronto zone against Finger. Put it through the slot. Park couldn't get a stick down. Tomasarek rammed to the boards and down to the ice by Sim. Good hard hit by
yes.
John Sim.
Arms were down. Legs did not come off the ice. No elevation into it. Good classic body check along the wall.
Now strike stripped of the puck. Stajan working with Blake, feeds Blake, shoots, that's blocked by McDonald. The turnover created a chance. Andrew McDonald saved the Islanders there. Bailey back in, throws it on goal. Gustafsson makes the stop. Back at the blue line, Hillen. Down low, Gustafsson sweeps it away. Now the Karam lands behind the net. Nielsen takes it, turning on Jeff Finger.
Reminiscent of Carolina almost there with the puck caroming off the end wall. And the play where Tavares bunted it in.
That one hopped over Bailey's stick. Now he takes it out of the corner, turns it over to Phil Kessel. Kessel, a dynamic offensive player. And Nielsen recovers, sends Hillen in. Jack Hillen pulls up. Fingers swats away at the puck. Hillen still in there. Gets it back. Hillen shoots off of Gustafsson.
See how big he made himself there? He went down to the butterfly early, but he kept the shoulders chest square, chest up.
Now Oposo along the boards. Oposo out in front. Sutton joined the play and missed. Now he's trapped. The forward's going to have to cover. It's Schremp. Kessel working on Gervais. Takes the shot. Gervais gave him nothing. Very important and good play there by Bruno Gervais.
Well, first of all, good back pressure by four of the Islanders coming back, helping out with Andy Sutton. Also, though, fortunately, the Leafs were tired. That's what happens when you spend 20, 30 seconds in your own zone. You have to change. And so, therefore, Kessel was, he was lone wolf going by himself.
Tomasarek behind the Toronto goal. 8:02 remaining in the opening period. Shots are 5-2 Toronto. Ioannou knocked down. And that drive off the stick of Primo deflects out of play. 7:54 remaining. Scoreless first period on the island.
Andy McDonald with his stick to the middle after a turnover. Watches Jason Blake's going to skate into him right here. McDonald then gets himself set. Blake doesn't make a move. She tries to get the puck off quickly. McDonald, though, positions himself beautifully right there. Makes a nice block. There's a shot going towards the net.
Saturday night on MSG Plus 2, John Tavares and the Islanders head to the Garden to face Marion Gaborik and the New York Rangers. Live coverage gets underway with Miller Lite game night at 6:30. Islanders Rangers Saturday night on MSG Plus 2. Rangers are in Florida tonight. They're tied 1-1 midway through the first period. Nareskovich for Florida, Drury for the Rangers.
Drury's starting to get more of a role. Remember, in the game here a few games ago, he got sent to the fourth line. Played some penalty kills well. Heads up.
2-on-1 developing. Sim to Park. Park closes in. The pass missed Sim, who was being ridden along by Nikolai Kuhlman, number 41 for Toronto. So Wayne Primeau, number 18. Chips it deep. Goes after it in the corner. He's hit by Witt. They both take a tumble, and the Islanders come out. Park was looking for a pass that was well behind him. And so the puck back in the Islanders' zone. Taken by Gervais. Now for Witt. Brendan Wick got it as far as the Toronto line, and then Thompson jams it deep. And the Islanders change on the move. Grabowski up right wing. Checked from behind by Tavares. That forces the turnover with a lot of help behind Tavares. And Gustafsson has to gather that back in as Comeau's right on the doorstep.
So far, the Islanders doing a pretty solid job against the speedy players. The Toronto Maple Leafs, and also they've done a pretty decent job of getting it on the forecheck. This is a few minutes ago. Look at how Komisarek turns, doesn't protect himself at all, and nobody seems to yell at him. Then in comes John Sim, and then earlier, just a moment ago, Sim in transition goes down the ice. Kuhlman, man, you know what? Might have gotten him a little bit, but still, I think that was a good no call there as Richard Park tried to sizzle the puck through the top of that blue paint.
The Leafs have not had a shot for over 12 minutes now, and this is a team that leads the NHL with almost 34 shots per game on average. 33.9 to be exact. So the Islanders keeping a team that loves to fire away off the board, or at least off the shots on goal board lately.
They've done a pretty good job against them off the rush. Andy Sutton's had a few gap closures.
Kessel gets a shot on, stopped by Rolison. As long as Kessel's out there, the Leafs will get some shots.
Yeah, but all the Islander D-men so far have done a nice job at controlling the space in front of them, not getting too deep and backing up and allowing the speedy forward to Toronto to get their jets going.
Tavares swings one right out in front. Nobody able to connect. Pounded off the boards by the stick of Ponikarovsky. And now Beauchemin slips it back into the Islanders' zone. And as we come down to 6 minutes remaining in the first period, Blake Comeau lifts it in. Finger chased by Nielsen. Nielsen put a good hit on Finger and wins the puck. Coming out towards the corner. Centering feed. Shen was there for Toronto. And the Leafs attack. This is Vallin. Throwing it into the corner. Decked along the way by Bruno Gervais. Islanders go the other way. Brendan Witt put it to the side of the net. Gustafsson off to Finger. Poso after Finger. And nice soft pass by Shen gets the Leafs out. Colt Nora banks it off the board. And Gervais takes it back. Josh Bailey with Nielsen. Nielsen drops it off. Vallin slapped it into the corner so that his teammate Cabrelet could get there. Tomas Cabrelet. Head on left wing now to Primeau. Driving to the net. Tried a one-hander. He was given very little room by Mark Streit. Stepniak. Shoved a couple of times by Trent Hunter. Lee Stepniak all the way to Cabrelet. He's got a big shot when he gets the room to take it. But the wrister was tipped wide.
And he's also has an effective release on his shot, as you saw right there. He will wind up, but probably more than anything, Howie, he'll just get the puck through. And that's a skill that a lot of D-men have to continue to practice on. But Cabrelet's got that given talent of knowing when to punch it and when to just to get rid of it and get it wide.
Dump in by Ioannou. Hunter follows. Sounded like he might have broken his stick. He didn't. He just shanked the shot. way we've seen stick snap this year, it's almost miraculous that one didn't, the way wound up shooting it. Now finger off the boards. That's kept alive at the line, ultimately by Hillen. Sets up Hunter, who's met behind the net by Finger. Hunter stays with it all the way to the line to Hillen. Hunter knocked down in front. Hillen for Uwensu. And now Hunter again. Clean pass out to the line. Shrimp shot went wide. And it's lifted out of the zone. 3:43 remaining first period. Shots are 6-4 Islanders with no score. Mark Streit chasing. He's being chased by Ponikarovsky. Ponikarovsky finishes hard on Streit, but the Islanders have the puck. Perhaps an icing, and they do call the icing as Beauchemin got there first.
I was going to say, it was a good play by Mark Streit to take the hit, to make the reverse play to get it out, and I thought perhaps that Ron Wilson's club would have the icing nullified against them. That Natalie dressed.
That's
Ron
a great
Wilson.
Suit, isn't it?
It is. It's an outstanding suit. Nice tie and shirt combination right there. And Ron Wilson's had a lot of nice suits in his 565 career wins.
We'll get that from your guy in Montreal. Does he have his own very special tailor?
He's Willie. I mean, he's Wills. He's got his own guy, I'm sure. You know, Wills has got all of his own.
I would think the tailors in Toronto would be lining up to dress the Leafs coach. Now Beauchemin. Tied up by Molson. Tavares in there as well. Puck came out in front. And Phil Kessel brings it out for Toronto. Working on strike. Kessel looks for some help. Slides it down low. Ponikarovsky to Beauchemin. That's blocked by a sliding Molson. And a two-on-one now. Tavares with Comeau. Tavares hooked the shot, but that went partially and perhaps largely off the stick of White.
It did. White was beautifully placed in the middle. Heads up.
It's a lead for Kessel. He cuts in. Kessel can't get a shot off. Penalty at least. Maybe a penalty shot. Let's see.
How will they call this one? I think it's just going to be a hook. Or they're going to call it a hold. It's just going to be a hold, not a penalty shot. We've seen it going both ways this year.
So the Leafs will have the power play when we get back. 2:21 remaining, first period on the island.
On action, John Tavares had no choice but to shoot the puck here. We're going to stop the play. Look at the stick right there of Blake Comeau. He taps it seconds before, and it snaps in half. Will somebody please build a stick that will stay in two right now? Jeez. Right there, he puts a little pressure on it, and there leads to Tavares having to shoot the puck. The other way they go, the other way. There's John Sim at the end. He just gets a little bit of the reach on Phil Kessel.
Well, that could have been a penalty
Well, it could have been.
He was clear.
But we've seen guys be clear this year, and they still, the puck was to the side of the net. He wasn't in the motion of shooting, so they elected not to give him a penalty shot. That was a good penalty by John Sim to take there.
Well, the Islanders now go to the penalty kill, and we'll give you the specifics of just how difficult that's been for them lately. The Leafs' power play's no great shakes either. Just one for its last 13, although overall they're 12th in the league. The Islanders have Hillen, Sutton, Thompson, and Park trying to kill the penalty. Comberley and Beauchemin have the points. Down the boards comes Kessel with Stajan and Ponikarovsky on the power play. Stajan centers, slapped away. Beauchemin jumps in and then slides it back to Ponikarovsky. Now Kessel tees it up, blocked again by Sutton. Another big block by Sutton. Beauchemin for Kessel. He feeds Stajan down low, put it out in front. It was missed by Kessel, but kept in at the line at least temporarily, and then it came over the line. And so the play is offside, and you might know the numbers. The Islanders have allowed 18 power play goals their last 40 times shorthanded.
Now two of them came last game against Toronto Maple Leafs. First shot was by Francois Beauchemin, a straight down the middle shot. And then a little after that, deep in is the shot from Ian White. Two defensemen, first two goals of the game. The Isles responded with two power play goals of their own. Actually, that second one wasn't a power play. It was the second after a penalty expired to the Isles. But John Tavares had two power play goals of his own, only to see Jason Blake score the game-winning goal late in the third period in that game.
The Leafs now need a couple of hundred feet. The Islanders have Nielsen and Oposo with Witt and Gervais. And the Leafs with Ian White carrying out. Up the left wing for Blake. Former Islander Jason Blake with a shot stopped by Rolison.
You got to wonder about that shot right there. He goes, tries to go short side. Where is that going? That's going nowhere right there.
44 to the power play for Toronto. Blake hit by Gervais. We're into the final minute of the first period. Stempniak holds it in. Let's one go. That broke Oposo's stick. So Grabowski around to Hagman. Oposo staying on despite now not having a stick. Hagman working on that side along with Stempniak, who shot blocked by Oposo. He swept it out with his glove.
Great positioning. And Kyle knew that he had to stay up there. When you don't have your stick as a penalty killer, you do not run around. You do not, because you're much smaller without the length of your stick.
Blake on the loose puck. 6 seconds left to the power play. In behind for Hagman. This will take care of the penalty. Sim out of the box. I believe Sim just slammed the door on his face. Now gets up. Has a breakaway. Sim moving in. Denied by a very aggressive Gustafsson.
6 foot 3 inch aggressive Gustafsson. As he comes out, he sprawls. And he makes a monster-like save. As the puck is whipped at the blue line by Stempniak, Comeau gets it up to John Sim. He tries going back. And did you notice, though, there, folks, he actually had it a little far out in front of him. He lost it for half a second. Watch as the puck comes up here. He's going to bobble it right there. And so he doesn't get it close enough to his body. He wanted to make that move about 5 feet before that, where he ended up doing that, Howie. He had to reach out for the puck.
It also looked to me as that Sim had a little trouble getting out of the penalty box. It looked like the door actually hit him in the face on the way out.
Gotta be careful, those doors. You never know what they're going to do. They're unpredictable. Wow.
Well,
ask him about it.
I, I'm not sure that that's exactly what happened, although I saw him stumble a little bit on his way out of the box, and it looked to me like that's what happened. He did get the breakaway. Gustafsson beat him, and you'll have a chance to ask him about that, should you choose.
That'll be my first question. Did the door hit you in the face?
You know the old expression, and Sim was mindful not to make that the message. And the Islanders and Leafs play a scoreless first period here at the Nassau Veterans Memorial Coliseum. What do they say? Don't let the penalty box door hit you on the way out. We'll find out. Intermission is next.
Now, BMW will make your first.
Welcome back to the Coliseum. No score here between the Islanders and the Maple Leafs. My guest this intermission, John Sim. A very active first period for you, John. Is it the type of game that you guys expected it to be?
Yeah, you know, it's a good pace game out there. And trying to get some energy, trying to get the guys up. You know, we're coming off some losses, and this is a huge game for our team.
How is the attitude of the team right now? I mean, you go out, and you guys seem to be playing very well, especially at 5-on-5. How's the attitude on the bench, the feel of the team?
Yeah, it's good. You know, we just got to keep being positive. You know, there's still a long stretch of games left here. We're by no means out of it. We just got to stay positive and keep going. This is a big game for sure.
End to end for you. First of all, you take what I called a very good penalty when you helped eliminate a breakaway opportunity. Then, when you come out of the penalty box, you get a breakaway of your own. Did you lose the puck, a little control of the puck right there, and therefore you couldn't make the move as early as you'd like on the breakaway?
I think I was a little dazed coming out of the box. I kind of whacked myself coming out.
Blame it on the timekeeper, the doorkeeper.
I kind of pushed it a little far ahead, and he made a great play coming out to poke check like that, and it was a nice save. You know, unfortunately, but we're going to get more breaks here.
All right, John, thanks for joining us here. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Billy.
All right, John Sim, our guest here. No score at the end of one. We got more intermission coming up. Be careful of the doors, Butch and Deb. You never know what they might do.
Back at the Coliseum, happy holiday season's greetings. No score yet between Toronto and the Islanders. Deb Placey and Butch scoring after 20 minutes. Islanders kept Toronto from scoring on the power play, but both of their special units have changed.
Yeah, they really have. And the power play, Kyle Oposo was on sort of what I call the big power play with Tavares and Molson. And what they did is they moved Hillen to play with straight on the points. So that's a subtle little change. Didn't get the result I'm sure they wanted to. At least they didn't score a goal. And then Kyle Oposo obviously went to the second power play. But for me, more interestingly, was the penalty kill. They made what I would call a huge adjustment. They controlled the slot area a lot more. I could see that the top penalty killers were paying a lot more attention to the slot area than they had in the last 5 or 6 games.
Okay, John Sim talked about in his interview with Billy that he likes the pace of play, that he likes the way his team has gone out there. Not too many shots on goal, but we'll talk about some of the hits in this game. Is it as physical as you thought it would be?
Well, it's, everybody seems to, you know, enjoy the hitting and they keep track of it and all, but to me, it didn't look like they had the energy that I've seen them in past games. And to me, what it looks like, Deb, is that it looks like it's hard work. Sometimes you watch the guys play and there's a lot of fluidity smoothly out there, and everything seems to be relatively smooth. Well, today it looks to me like the guys are working real hard. There's a physical game, and there's a lot of hits out there. But if you notice, and you're watching the shifts, at the very end of the shifts, the last 5 or 10 seconds, the guys are kind of dragging their butts to get off the ice. That tells me that it's real hard work today.
All right, looks like some of the guys are taking long shifts, or it just looks like they're taking long shifts.
Well, no, I don't think they're taking long shifts, but, you know, after 30 seconds, normally they can get off in a hurry. Today, it's a struggle for them to get off the ice.
All right, a shout-out to Bobby Mills, who got the... We are back. The Islanders' last game before the holiday break. Last game for everybody in the NHL before the Christmas break. This December schedule for the Islanders has been relentless. 10 games in these... final 18 days of December. We're in the middle of that stretch right now.
And I think that's why they're a little tired, dragging their butts, because there has been a lot of games, Deb.
All right, so some scoring chances in the first period. No score after one, but we'll still take a look at some highlights, beginning with John Sim.
Yeah, well, this, we're going to see a good hit there right off the bat. Of course, that you always expect that from John Sim. And there's a drive into the net, as he loves to do. And this is his chance to score here. Now, he needs to go back to his forehand, because that's a Johnny Bauer-type move, incidentally, from Toronto Maple Leafs. And Kyle Poster, just still a little bit snake-bitten, but listen, at least he's still shooting the puck, and that's what he talked about before the game. He's going to continue to shoot. Eventually, it's going to go in. And of course, Rolson was jolly on his toes off in the game himself. So, you know what? It was a good, solid period for both teams.
Even though we don't have a score, we still have a first period scoring summary, and it is brought to you by your Tri-State Ford dealers. As we take a look at some of the stats from the first period, how about block shots? 10-5 in favor of the Islanders.
Yeah, the Islanders are still doing a lot of blocking of the shots there. One of the things I want them to do, though, is I want them to get in the slot. I want them to have a little more patience in the slot area. That puck will come there. Bossy did pretty well, didn't he?
All right, we'll look for that in the next period. Get guys in the slot. You can score from the center of the ice.
Exactly.
Back after this.
Good angle.
Score at the end of one. As we head towards the second, another strong period from Andy Sutton to reflect on, Billy.
Yeah, there's a reason why he leads his team in block shots. Watch his gap control. The puck's over here along the wall. Andy Sutton, though, is back here. Go ahead and roll it, guys. Phil Kessel's going to bring it up. Now watch as Andy Sutton right in here. Stop it right in there. See the area? It's not that big where Andy Sutton is. Go ahead and roll it. He's one-on-one with Kessel. Good shot block right there. Makes a nice, subtle, simple play. We're going to go a little later in the period. I really like this play for Andy Sutton right here. There's Andy Sutton. Go ahead and roll it again now. With the puck going to be coming up here, stop it right there. First of all, Bailey back pressure, stick to the inside. Andy Sutton closing the gap right there. Go ahead and roll it. Watch what happens right there. Stick the puck right there. And then this part of the play I like too. Bailey's going to get it. He's going to look right up the middle. He has an outlet. He has support through the middle. Right there, he gets it up to Franz Nielsen. Islanders get the puck then through the neutral zone into the offensive zone. Sutton with 3 block shots in the first.
He has been absolutely terrific for this team since coming back from his most recent foot injury. And he said the foot's feeling fine. Everything that has been banged up on Andy Sutton, which is just about everything over the last couple of years, is feeling fine. It's about as good as he's felt over the last couple of years. And he's now taken to mentoring some of these young Islander defensemen, and no one more closely than a guy he's been paired with lately, and that is Jack Hillen. And Sutton was saying earlier that he remembers early in his career, remember a defenseman named Bob Rouse who played for the North Stars and later the Maple Leafs? And
yep.
He said that Rouse was a big influence on Andy Sutton's career, helping him get through a long schedule and deal with the ups and downs the way he's now doing with Jack Hillen.
Everybody needs a mentor. They really do. This game, experience is so, it's just so invaluable. And to have somebody that will take the time to teach you not just the physical aspect of it, but the mental, the emotional part of it is huge.
Matt Stajan for Toronto. As the Leafs gain immediate entry into the Islanders zone to start this second period. The Islanders' Sim put it off of Cabrelet, and then it ricochets all the way towards the Toronto goal. And so Gustafson forced to do some house cleaning. And it's kicked along by Ponikarovsky. Jack Hillen after it. As the Leafs begin to change on the move. And now Sutton. Ahead for Park into the Toronto zone. Sim with a drive, and that hit a leg on its way through. Kuhlman to Stempniak. And now Kuhlman with a shot. Stick save made by Rolison. Luke Shen drives one off of Franz Nielsen. Yeah, Toposo for the Islanders starts towards the Toronto zone. Banks one neatly to himself. Takes it behind the net. Now sets up Gervais, and he hit the side of the net.
We were talking to Ron Wilson about that exact type of play before the game, where the players are now passing the puck to himself more than we've ever seen, because the Dino can no longer stop them. They can't shadow them and slow them down. You touch them, you know it's going to be a penalty.
Gulliman for Toronto feeds it across. Rollison was headed over that way, but Brendan Witt made sure it wasn't necessary. Well, nice again, play by Witt,
because his spacing was on there. It was real tight, and he was able to make a very tough play. Actually looked somewhat easy.
That hopped over a Poso stick. Leafs looked to go the other way. Bailey wouldn't allow it. And now a little touch feed from Grabowski to Jason Blake. In over the line for Hagman. Nick Hagman with a pass to the stick of Blake that was deflected wide. White with a pass down low off of Grabowski's stick. And it's Comeau up the right wing for the Islanders. Into the Toronto zone, held off ever so slightly by Beauchemin. That's about all you can do now. That's
a good subtle play there within the rules. Beauchemin is a kind of cagey veteran that can do that kind of play. He's also a big man, and so tough to move around.
Nick Hagman with a dump in that Blake chases, but Strike got to it first for the Islanders. And now Tavares nudges it ahead to Molson. Blake scooting back into center. Jason Blake now loses it to Strike. Islanders in deep. Strike looking, shooting. That's blocked by Blake. Or pardon me, by Beauchemin. Comeau around to the other side. Blake Comeau trying to shake loose of Grabowski. Komisarov whacking away at him too. Tavares plays it back to the line. McDonald off the end boards. Ricochets out in front. And Comeau now hemmed in by Vallin. Beauchemin knocks it off the boards. Blake couldn't get it past Strike. The Islanders keep it in. Beauchemin smacking away at it. And now it's taken by Komisarov. And Beauchemin with room. The teams are changing. And he fired a drive ahead looking for Blake. That allowed for two things: to get the puck deep and for Beauchemin to get off. As long as you move that towards a teammate, they'll give you the benefit of the doubt. So Hunter with a shot knocked aside and recovered by Gustafson. 16:33 to go, second period. Saturday night day after the Islanders-Rangers game on MSG Plus.
The ever entertaining show that is Hockey Night Live. Never quite know what one of those guys is going to say.
I'm not sure they do either.
That's just part of the beauty of it.
Complete spontaneity.
Uh-huh.
Phil Kessel drops one off to Shen. Of course, Al Troutwood will tell you that everything is scripted carefully, which is it simply
maybe
plays
for
the,
him.
It plays to the brilliance of those on the panel, making it look extemporaneous. Gabrielle,
you can't use those words on 4 hours sleep.
That'll teach you. Yoensu back in the Islanders zone. Well, now you know what you could read on the planes in the morning.
If I keep my eyes open.
Kessel runs into his own man, gets the shot anyway. And that sails over the net. That's O-V-E-R.
Thank you. Hit the ref, Carey Frazier. Almost a good bounce for Maple Leafs there. No icing here as the puck was deflected on the way down to Gustafson.
Yes, Billy, it was. And Komisarov for the Maple Leafs around the white. Did the C-18 the other night. Primo down the boards, looking for Kuhlman down low. Now Kuhlman turns, strong on the puck, lifts one towards the net, grabbed back by Stempniak, recovered again by Strike.
You see Kuhlman using 6'1"
pass there.
Yep, yep. His 6'1", 225-pound frame very well, and that's what he's been doing, driving, using the shoulders, getting him and turning, and getting him on the inside and turning the body, going to the front of the net. A pretty good pace to this game right now, as both teams have played a very clean game, a hard skating game. And up and down the ice, both coaches are going to look at this and say, all right, we beat Chad some opportunities, but they haven't got a lot of shots through the net. Both teams have blocked shots pretty well in this game. Just a total of 14 shots at this time. A lot of skating, but not a lot of what you would say great quality shots on net.
And we're 5 minutes into the second period. Josh Bailey for the Islanders, checked by Colt Knorr along the boards. Moore, Vallin, and Mayers, the checking line for the Maple Leafs. Islanders with Nielsen, Bailey, and Poso, and here comes Bailey. He's surrounded right now, takes the shot, he went up high, and Gustafson grabs it.
But again, there's that back pressure, Howie, and so it's basically, it's Bailey against two or three blue sweater Toronto Maple Leafs right there. And so he's got to put it up high in Gustafson. Scott Gordon's squad trying to challenge the big guy known as the Monster. What I'd like to see, you know, there's a kind of a book on Gustafsson. If you get a shot, if you get an opportunity kind of in, give him a little fake, give him a little drop, and he'll drop. He will go down quickly. He's still, you know, tree training into that butterfly mood work, method. You know, he worked on it, used his athleticism a ton as a goalie playing in the Swedish Elite League. But this year, he's gotten into training on the ice and training off the ice as well. It's really the old saying, it's a real work in progress with Gustafsson. They've been happy, though, with his development, especially the last few weeks.
Beauchemin bothered by the forecheck of Oposo. Kyle gets the puck back, looking for space or a teammate. And it's strike. Winding it in behind the net, grabbed by Nielsen. That went off the stick of White, and Jason Blake looks to scoot forward, working on McDonald. Blake pulls up, McDonald giving him nothing. Good job there by Andrew McDonald. Then Hagman applied pressure, and Blake winds it in behind the Islander net. Grabowski to the other side for Toronto. Blake now on that same side. He went, as you would say, east to west. And Comeau comes down the board. Carvalet with a pair of Islanders on him. And it's Oposo hustling it ahead for Franz Nielsen. Blake got it back and bounces it in. 13:29 to go, second period. Shots are 9-6 Islanders with no score. McDonald put it off the stick of Kessel. That forces the play offside. 13:20 remaining. Second period on the Island.
Well, you're not seeing a lot of offensive opportunities for either hockey club, but the New York Islanders are creating some speed up the ice, and that is happening because the outlet passes from the defensemen are right on the sticks. Very important if you're going to create any kind of offense, because trying to play the puck along the boards is always tough for the wingers. Those tape-to-tape passes, they're important.
And Butchie, you know, you've watched this team all year long, and they like that long stretch pass if they can, strong side. Get things going with speed, and especially if they can get guys slashing up through the neutral zone with speed to get on the forecheck, that's ideal.
The draw outside the Toronto blue line. And it's pounded in by Hillen. Makes an odd ricochet to the stick of Ian White for the Maple Leafs. Islanders going with the Tavares line. Comeau still flanking Tavares on the right with Matt Molson on the left. Hillen and Sutton, the defense pair. And now Molson starts ahead. For Comeau, and a blocker save by Gustafsson.
That was a good shot. That was one the goalie had to extend himself on there. Nice quick shot by Comeau.
Tavares lost it to Kessel. Tries to slide it down low. That's broken up.
Good D. Five sweaters and White coming back.
Yeah, Blake Comeau did a great job in busting back to negate what would have been a 3-on-2. Konikarovsky, nice move, shoots. And Rolison's got it with a little help from his left wing, Matt Molson.
Nice play by Ponikarovsky as he drags the puck back into his body while putting on the brakes. And as he's going to do that, Danny Sutton's going to come back. Watch right here. Sutton's going to slide in. Now, it wasn't Sutton. It was actually Hillen that ends up bumping his goaltender Rolison a little bit. And I think, right in the crease as well as staging. I think that's what Dwayne Rolison was talking about to the official Carey Fraser, as if to say, wait a second, got to let me play the puck cleanly in my crease area there. It was a nice play, though, by Ponikarovsky, and a nice save by Rolison.
Remember, we're talking about a Toronto team here that, as we mentioned before, averages 33.9 yep. shots a game. We've got 12:28 left in the second period. The Leafs have 7 shots on goal. Just 2 of them in this period. They've had 14 shots blocked by the Islanders. Andy Sutton's had a lot to do with that. Not the only one, of course. 7 more have missed the net, so they've taken 28 attempts. They've only been able to get a quarter of them to the net. Stempniak sends Kuhlman in. And now Carvalet up for Kuhlman. He's checked by Andrew McDonald. And Wayne Primeau dumps it in. Last time Wayne Primeau scored was the first game between these teams in Toronto on the 23rd of November. He's gone 15 games in a row now without a goal, but Wayne Primeau.
But what he's done, when Mitchell got hurt, John Mitchell, that is, his offside, he's called there on the regroup.
Oh, I think Komisarek's stick came up on Nate Thompson.
That might have been. Nate Thompson actually might have barreled over Komisarek, and it might have been the skate.
That's even worse.
We'll get a look at it coming up here. Garrett Timms on immediately.
I'm sorry, I just saw a look on the scoreboard that you're going to see now.
Watch the left skate, I believe. No, the right skate.
Oh, boy, is
that close. Oh man. It was just an inadvertent. I mean, obviously, you know, Thomas Eric's going forward, looking for the hit. Thompson's barreling down the left wing. And by the grace of an inch or two, it looks like. Oh, not even. Oh, boy.
First thing, of course, you worry about in those situations with any degree of specificity is the eye, you know. Did it?
Well, they're saying it. Wait, went off the ice. Usually when it's major, I mean, there's a lot of bleeding and there's something coming right out of that eye. It looks like they're saying in the truck it's the eyebrow area. Well, that's great news. But still, I mean, you're talking a matter of literally an inch there.
Here's Gervais firing, and that hit a leg, and there's going to be a penalty here against the Maple Leafs, and the Islanders will go to the power play.
I believe it's going to be a slash on Finger as the Islanders drove to the net. I believe Finger was the one that came down with the stick. And the Islanders
Toronto
hit the
penalty, number 4, 2 minutes for slashing.
Yep, Terry Frazier makes that announcement. Bruno Gervais is going to get the puck coming in, and he's going to get the quick shot off right there in front of the net. Here's the slash as Joensuu drives through to the front. Joensuu going to the right area of the ice to make his 6'4" frame even more useful for the Islanders, helps draw a penalty. John Sim goes off the ice now as well. I believe that is an equipment issue, though.
So the draw deep in the Toronto zone as the Islanders start the power play. And they've got Molson, Tavares, Schrempf, Streit, and Oposo, with Oposo playing the point. Islanders are 2-for-7 on the power play against the Maple Leafs this year, 0-for-1 tonight with 2 shots. Finger for the slash. At 8:44, Primo and Kuhlman up front, Shen and Beauchemin back for Toronto on the penalty kill.
Islanders' Mark Streit is the one who's going to carry the puck up the ice, but every team that they're playing against right now is they've pre-scouted that. They know that, and they're shutting the door on him numerous times, making it very difficult for the Islanders to get clear setting into the offensive zone.
Kept alive by Streit at the line, and the drive by Oposo, sticked aside by Gustafsson. Now Oposo for Schrempf to the feet of Streit. And now Tavares. Tavares floats one down low. Beauchemin bursts in to pick it off and clear. 57 seconds remain to the power play. Quick feed ahead by Rollison. And Robbie Schrempf now weaving towards the Toronto blue line. There were 4 Leafs there. Poke it away. And Beauchemin clears. 40 seconds remain to the power play. Now it's Hillen. Moving to the Toronto line. Again, they spread 4.
Now that could have been interference right there. I've seen that one called before.
Matt Stajan clears one all the way down. Now the crowd's getting a little antsy. And Butch, you played the power play, you killed penalties. What's the approach the Islanders need to do here?
Well, when you stand 4 guys up at the blue line, you have to dump it in. And that's something that Ronnie Wilson has always believed. He used to say, when I killed was I on the power play, the hardest thing for me to get that puck in is when there was 4 guys across. So he encourages defenses, 4 blue guys, to stand on the blue line. There he
goes. Off the toe drag from Hunter. He beats Gustafsson just as Finger came out of the box. It's an even strength goal.
Toe dragged in and beats him far side. Gustafsson plays the angle hard to his right. Look at that little laser. And you know what? Let's give Bailey credit. Josh Bailey, that beautiful press. You know what he does? He takes the eyes of Jonas Gustafsson there just enough away from the puck for that half a second that it allows it to get in. Butch was talking about, as I mentioned earlier, you know, if you're going to try and carry the puck past 4 guys at the blue line, it's near impossible. These guys are too good, too mobile, too big. They finally, you know, they get the puck deep, get it deep, send 2 or 3 bodies at the puck, retrieve it, and then set your power play up.
Fingers shot batted in with a high stick.
Goal, no goal.
Well, it was waved off instantly. The reason is obvious. Now, of course, they'll probably go upstairs and check.
Well, you could read Ron Wilson's lips right there.
Ball in the play. The puck was put in the net with a high stick.
He said over the crossbar. And, yes, that is the correct call made by Dean Morton, the other official working this game, along with Perry Frazier. Blake right there, no question about it. Well above the crossbar. It's nice hand-eye coordination, but it doesn't count in this game.
Dean Morton is waiting over by the scorer's table.
They might look at it, but this should be the world's quickest review.
I think they've passed any further review without stopping the game here. Generally, in a situation like that, if there's any sense of question whatsoever, then Toronto will probably initiate the review, meaning, of course, the situation room in Toronto, but they're not even doing that because it was so obvious. So, 1-0 Islanders. Hunter's goal again, not a power play goal. It came 3 seconds after Finger came out of the box.
Second in two games for Hunter.
But again, Finger was not back in the play. It might just as well have been a power play goal.
Absolutely. You would not call it a textbook power play goal either, would you? I mean, it's just a quick shot from the side. When all else fails, took the puck on net.
Now Park up to the Toronto line. Drop for Comeau to Park for a drive and a save. Gustafson. Kessel missed the puck. Como's got it back. Feeds Sutton. Andy with a drive off the back of the net. Joensuu forced into the corner by Stajan. Remember the Leafs had 62 shots against the Islanders in Toronto in an overtime game? They've had eight here. Eight shots all game. 8:03 to go, second period. Stajan up for Kessel. Blake trailing. And Comeau brings it in. Comeau powering towards the net. He draws the goaltender down. Centers. Tavares scores! John Tavares! And the Islanders lead it 2-0.
There's that fake I was talking about. Did you notice how Gustafson dropped down quickly and overplayed that initial shot? And then the Islanders open up the middle of the ice. John Tavares slams in the goal. It's going to be his 16th of the year. Quick transition up the ice. Comeau with good support there. Right here, he's going to fake. Gustafson's way down. He's completely out of the play. That is one thing that he really needs to work on this game. And the Islanders exploit that beautifully. Tavares from Comeau makes it 2-0.
Why did Tavares need that? It's not only his first goal in seven games, but he has really struggled in five-on-five situations. Not just, you know, to find the back of the net, but to get the scoring chances that he was getting earlier in the year.
Well, that one, he drove to where he's supposed to. He had great support in the neutral zone, first of all, from Blake Comeau. You know, you've got teammates. It's not just about supporting your own zone. It's all zones on the ice. And Comeau, by scooping that puck up with speed, Howie, being so close to John Tavares, helped initiate that odd-man rush.
Well, the Islanders with a two-goal lead. Comeau and Hillen on the assist. 12-17.
By the way, quick update. John Sim back from his equipment fix, and also Nate Thompson, we're just told as well, back on the bench as well. That's great news.
Gervais plays it across to Witt. Oh, the Islanders, with two goals in a minute and a half, have taken the lead for John Tavares, his team leading 16th goal of the year. And the Islanders have broken through, first Hunter, then Tavares.
All right, what I really like about this play, it's involved many different things. Here's Jack Hillen. He's going to put the puck off the wall here. And it's good at the neutral zone. There's a little chip by Sutton. Stop it right in there. Watch coming up is Blake Comeau, and you'll see him hit the inside here. Go ahead and roll it, guys. As he goes, Tavares right there does an inadvertent pick on Beauchemin as well. And then the rest, as they say, is history. Tavares goes drive hard to the net, stick down. Little fist pump right there as well to celebrate. Look, folks, how close that skate blade came to Nate Thompson die. I mean, that's not even an inch. That's not even an inch. And, you know, I totally get it why some players don't like wearing shields. I do. It's different. You know, you feel like you have a different line of sight or vision and everything. But man, oh man, when you see that, you thank your lucky stars. Oh, you know, makes you wonder why everybody does it. But again, I get it, Howie. I do.
Well, Nate Thompson has to consider himself extremely fortunate when you look at how close those cuts were to the eye. So thankfully, Nate's okay. And the Leafs in the Islanders zone. Comeau as the puck hit him. Now Andrew McDonald around the boards.
I just think with where shots are coming from now and how many guys are having to block them. There's more deflections than ever in the National Hockey League. There's more hits that are up high that involve the face and everything. Now, you know, it makes sense, especially for every young player coming up. They got to wear it. In the American Hockey League now, it's mandatory for everybody. You think it's getting closer where just about everybody eventually will wear them.
Carbele up for Shen. That one went a little too far. And Shrimp dumps it in. .522 remaining here in the second period. 14-8 Islanders in shots. Leafs trying to come out here. Grabowski for Hagman on left wing. Sutton's there. Well, it's Festivus season. Another Festivus feat of strength by Andy Sutton to eliminate Nick Hagman. He's been doing that all year. But of course, it's Festivus for the rest of us.
Welcome back to the Coliseum. Watch this little play right there by Blake Comeau to go to the inside with Tavares from the down low look. Getting himself, you know, just in the right spot in front of Francois Beauchemin. Beauchemin is a wide body player as it is. He's 6 foot, 215 pounds. But because of Comeau's acceleration and Tavares is just putting his body right there for a half second, that opened up that inside seam. And Howie, you will talk with Blake Comeau. You could ask him about that very play.
It'll be a probing session. And I hope you'll be there for it.
I will. I'll be listening.
In our intermission. Just as you were able to squeeze that information out of John Sim before, confirming our suspicion that he did run into the penalty box door on the way out.
That's what a good journalist does.
That's it, Mr.
Not that I ever call myself.
Oh, no. You're all Mike Wallace now.
Oh, yeah.
Here's Blake. Pinned in by Sutton. Carbele nudges it off the glass. 4:45 remaining here in the second period. And here comes Sin, free of any impediments, getting it into the Toronto zone. And now Finger glides one ahead. Kessel blows by the now fallen Thompson. Nice feed to Blake. Back to Kessel. Oh, and Rollison busted the whole play. Boy, the Leafs did everything right there. But then there's the goaltender, Jason Blake. Coming out the other side, threw it through the slot. Held quickly at the line by Komisarek. Blake staging. Komisarek steps up, shoots. That's blocked by Sutton. And Comeau plays it off the glass. There is no more dominant position in all of sports than the goaltender in hockey. And you do everything right the way the Leafs just did, and then you run into a goaltender, makes a perfect save. Can frustrate a team.
Well, I thought at first, the naked eye, I thought they actually was one too many passes, but Blake's pass back to the low slot to Kessel ended up being beautiful. But the thing was even more, was the positioning of Dwayne Rollison getting right over their square.
Beauchemin on the shot. Rollison saw that too through traffic.
And holds on to that puck too. Just absorbs it right into the Islanders' crest right there. Earlier, this is the players. The pressing the play is the Maple Leafs. Kessel with some real good footwork getting back up. See, I thought the Kessel, I beg your pardon, Blake, had Sutton beat to the outside. I thought he would drive to the net, but he put it back to the slot area. And Dwayne Rollison made a save, and then another save, and then this save as well. I love the focus again, how you see the eyes all the way, follows the puck all the way into that sweater, the crest of his right there.
And now Ronz Nielsen thrown out of a draw. So Bailey will take it instead against Primo, who wins it back to White. Ian White cuts down the boards. White still with it. Caromed away from Bailey. And Oposo misses Nielsen. And Witt fires it ahead. Primo had the stick knocked out of his hands, had to reach back to pick it up. Now he's got it. He's got the puck, too. Primo runs into Oposo. Gervais works it out of the Islanders' zone. White off the boards for Kuhlman. Stepniak slowed down by Witt. And the Islanders' Oposo fires it ahead to Bailey. Josh Bailey puts a move on Finger. Now to Oposo. Nice move himself. Couldn't get the backhander off, though. And Hagman just scoops it off the boards. But McDonald made a good play to prevent a Blake rush from the Islander blue line in. So Shrimp the other way. Put it off the wall. Bailey and Strite looked at each other before Strite fired it in. 2:28 left. Second period. 2-0 Islanders. Gustafson almost gave that up to Shrimp. Stays in for McDonald. He shoots and that went wide. Hard carom to Hagman. He saw him pick his head up. Spot Grabowski's got Blake going to the net. Little tiny things like that. The head up by Hagman.
Big time head up, but also another little tiny thing we just saw there from Dwayne Rollison, putting the puck from his right side blocker into the corner so Trent Hunter could pick it up in stride. That's a nice help on the breakout.
Strike for Ioensuu. Sarah got back for it. Haberlace makes it around the boards. Strike with a pinch. That kept it deep. Leafs get it again. Kamberle with an outlet for Grabowski. The Islanders had that reasonably well covered. And it's worked in behind the Toronto goal. Andy Sutton has blocked four shots. He's delivered four hits. He's been on for the even strength goal.
Well, maybe what you can't quantify is how much he's actually altered their plans at other times as well by just being out there. You know, when you're thinking about a guy 6'6", 200, almost 50 pounds going to come and rock it.
Here's Kessel firing and he missed the net. Great chance for Kessel. Good job jumping rope by Dean Morton, the referee. And we're down to the final minute of the second period. Caberle for White. Wrists one down low. That went off the skate of Park. And it was missed by Stajan. And the Islanders clear. And we'll be chatting with Blake Comeau in our second intermission. Butch and Deb will have highlights and analysis too. Now Kessel.
Oh, no, this is a real good shift to defense by Richard Park. Another opportunity for Kessel thwarted because he had a guy next to heads up.
And Stajan denied by Rollison, who's becoming a story here despite the fact that was only the 13th shot the Leafs had taken.
Andy Sutton would like to have that pass back.
And Wayne Rollison bailed him out. That's Sutton whose stick broke. Working without a stick at the corner, just 8 seconds left in the period. Now Hillen can run it out just by clearing, and he does. And the Islanders going to take a 2-0 lead into their room at the end of two periods.
Well, capitalizing on the opportunities given to you. Now first Trent Hunter with just a wicked shot, and then John Tavares with a beautiful finish off of a nice play from Blake Comeau results in a very solid second period. What I like best about this game, though, from the Islanders' perspective, is that they have eliminated time and space against the speedy top six of the Toronto Maple Leafs. They have really done a nice job against guys like Kessel and Blake and not allowed them to dangle the way that they want to. And as a result, only 13 shots on goal through two.
And so when you add it up, it is 2-0 Islanders at the end of 40 minutes. Brent Hunter got the Islanders on the board. And a nice rush by Blake Comeau, which turned into a goal after the Leafs had one disallowed. Tavares put it away. Our intermission begins after this. Welcome back to the Coliseum. It is 2-0 Islanders at the end of two periods. We're joined by Blake Comeau, made a gorgeous play to set up John Tavares for the game's second goal. And boy, you've had a strange season, haven't you? You get scratched a bunch of times, then you're up playing with John Tavares and creating scoring chances. What kind of yo-yo have you felt like this year?
Yeah, it's definitely been up and down. I tried to stay positive through the whole thing. Scott's done a good job of making it pretty simple for what he wants me to do game in and game out. And when I get my opportunity, I'm just trying to make the most of it.
Well, the obvious great play you made in this game was the one to set up John Tavares for the goal. Let's look at that first before we talk about a more subtle play. What's the communication like between you and John here?
Oh, it's getting better and better every game, even with Matt. Just like any line combination, the more you play together, the more you're going to get familiar with each other. And I knew John was going to the net there, and I just tried to get it out in front after the goalie went down.
Now, on the more subtle note, earlier in the period, The Leafs look like they're going to have a 3-on-2 going the other way, and you hit the gas and floored it and got back and cluttered that up, and the Leafs never got a scoring chance. In some ways, do you get as much satisfaction out of that as you do setting up a goal?
Oh, definitely. You know, coming to the bench, guys recognize that as well, and there's a few pats on the butt, and, you know, obviously that feels good. You know, talking with Scott, like I said, he wants me to be a two-way player and a guy that can get back. You know, so that's something I want to take pride in, is taking care of my own end as well as trying to help out offensively.
All right, Blake, nice going. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks,
we appreciate it.
Thanks.
That is Blake Comeau of the New York Islanders. Nice rush, nice pass to Tavares. And it is 2-0 Islanders at the end of two. We'll be back.
The 1983 Stanley Cup Finals was an NHL smackdown. Islanders, Oilers. Hockey's reigning dynasty going head-to-head with a dynasty waiting to happen. And you know what went down. Our dynasty said, not yet, Gretzky. Get in line. Number 99 and the Oilers were young and hungry, but they weren't quite ready for our experience. For how hard we checked them up and down the ice, and they definitely weren't ready for the brick wall we had in net. Billy Smith was cash money in that series, and he led us to our second straight final sweep and our fourth Stanley Cup in a row. It was the end of a beautiful run for the Isles, the dynasty's last gasp. But we didn't know that at the time. All we knew was that it was our time, and the great one was going to have to wait his turn.
What's your...
Trent Hunter and John Tavares, the two goal scorers for the Islanders. It's the Isles' first 2-0 lead since Blake Comeau's late goal at Madison Square Garden. And how about the play that Blake Comeau made? A narrow field behind the goaltender. Somehow got it through.
Didn't have a whole lot of room. But, you know, when you play with your guys a little while, you have a feel and you have a sense of what they're going to do. You don't have to look. He just threw it into the hole because he knew Tavares would be there.
All right, we've talked a lot about how the Islanders have been out shooting their opponents. Can we give them some credit for not allowing a lot of shots?
They're playing extremely well defensively, no doubt about that. Only giving up 13 shots at this point in time. And when they have given up shots, certainly Dwayne Wilson's been very good. And watch his positioning. Dwayne, when you hit the guy in the crest there, it means his position's absolutely perfect, and he's very stationary there. And when he's not moving a lot, he's always doing good things. But to get back to what they were talking about as far as, you know, the position of the Islanders overall, is that I love the way they're fronting the Toronto Maple Leafs. Like, the Toronto Maple Leafs haven't got nowhere to go there. The Islanders aren't chasing them. You know, you see some games where the Islanders always seem to be chasing their opponents. Well, tonight, they're not chasing. They're already in front of them. They have such good position. They have such good support. And, of course, the forwards are coming back hard to reinforce that support. So the Islanders are doing a great job.
And other than the one late pass by Andy Sutton, how about his game tonight?
Well, he's played extremely well. I mean, he's been great since he's got back. I mean, he's a big wide body, as Billy likes to say, and he's terrific at blocking shots. And I like the way he took the guy out there. Didn't try to hit him, just corralled him into the corner, pinned him, and that's what you really have to do. I mean, we've had so many things about guys getting their heads banged all over the place, but Andy Sutton's a guy that just plays very physical, but very clean.
All right, what's your favorite holiday tradition, Butch, other than eating turkey on Thanksgiving? Is it the classic? Maybe the Islanders will play in a winter classic in the next couple of years. I'm sure John Tavares would like that. 2-0 Isles after two. Back with more after this. Okay, back at the intermission. Islanders leading the Maple Leafs. They're shutting them out 2-0. We're going to check out the second period highlights. And, Butch, I have a feeling you're going to see Hunter and Tavares score in these highlights.
Exactly right. And we talked about the Islanders not being able to score goals and never be shy about shooting. Well, Trent Hunter never has that problem. Watch Bailey force his turnover. Now, Hunter, it's not a great angle, but he lets the shot go. Nice screen shot by Bailey getting in front. And just enough so that the monster couldn't quite pick it up, Gustafson. But that's what you have to do. Shoot the doggone puck. And this play, we've talked about Tavares' goal, but it's made by Comeau. Just a terrific play. And this is a goal scorer's goal because a lot of guys would have went by the net or not got themselves in position. But this play is made by Comeau's speed. Big goal for the Islanders.
Second period scoring summary brought to you by Hyundai. The Islanders have liked their play 5-on-5, so isn't it fitting that Trent Hunter's goal isn't a power play goal? It came 3 seconds later.
Yeah, and we talked about them facing the Maple Leafs all night, and that's why they're able to block all these shots. They've got them in front.
Assistant coach Dean Chenoweth is outside the Islanders' dressing room and joins us now.
Islanders are a +2. Up 2-0 going to the third. But Scott Gordon is very well aware that the third periods have not been the Islanders' best this year by any stretch. They've been outscored by a 2-1 margin in third periods.
What specifically, and I ask you this because it was interesting to hear Butch talk about the Islanders needing to keep taking it to the Leafs. Yep. Talking to Ron Wilson before, how there comes a point in third periods with everything so tight in the conference where you have to be smart and just chip pucks out and get them deep and don't take chances. Well, when does that more conservative element start to factor in?
No, right now. And it's not ultra conservative. It's just ultra smart. Another block by Sutton to start this period. Let's talk about it in a moment. About it's you don't just start playing passive hockey, but you play smarter hockey, sharper hockey now.
Well, Kuhlman throws it back to Komisarek for a shot that almost slithered through the pads of Rolison, but he's got it. And then everybody else does what's necessary to dislodge the net.
That is the 14th shot on goal that the Toronto Maple Leafs defensemen have attempted in this game. Just five have gotten through. That was the fifth one, that one, that wrist shot by Mike Komisarek. The Islanders done a real nice job of blocking shots coming from the point men in this game. And they don't usually allow him to get through. But that time, Rolison was right there. And all he's doing, he's saying, you know, you guys can all have your fun around me. I'm just going to hold my ground right here. But quickly, just to finish what you're asking. Look, right now, this is the time, even just a few seconds into the third period, as an Islander player now, you don't think, well, maybe I can get it in. You get the puck in. You don't say, well, maybe I can beat this guy one-on-one because I feel like I've got some speed going. If you know, if you can't do it, if there's any little hesitation, get rid of it. Get the puck out at your own blue line. Get the puck in at the offensive blue line. Nothing cute, nothing fancy, means nothing stupid, means you have a better chance of walking out, skating out with a victory.
And the Islanders come out of their own zone. Nielsen to Oposo. Now Kyle pulls up, throws it back to the blue line to McDonald. Down low, it got through. I think as much as anything, McDonald was looking for Bailey's stick. Mm-hmm. But that puck got all the way to Gustafson, who steered it aside. And then Bailey turns and smacks it off the board. It's a minute and 5 seconds into the third period. Brought out of the boards by Oposo. And recovered now by Wayne Primeau. His passes to the back of the skate of Parnikarovsky. And yet the Leafs were able to get it in there, although Stempniak was checked by some.
Well, he was checked by him again. He was by himself because the rest of his teammates were tired, having spent the previous 20 seconds in their own zone.
Robovsky doesn't connect with Blake. Matt Molson put it in, delayed offside. So Comeau and Tavares tag up, and that's wiped. And it's deep in the Islanders' zone. Hillen. Left it in the corner. Comeau is back. Komisarek, crisp feed to Carbele for a drive. Save. Rolison, rebound, score. It came loose, and Nick Hagman bats it past Rolison. The Islander lead is 2-1. At the 1:56 mark of the third period.
Well, this one doesn't get through either cleanly, but it gets through, and there's enough bodies there from the Maple Leafs that they're able to whack it in. I think you're going to see two Islander players attack one side. That leaves this left side wide open, and then you've got numbers in blue sweaters down low. Sutton can't get to his man Hagman, and he turns and he shoots and scores. But you're going to see the shot come through there. But again, you had two Islander players that went high left wing side. It was just too many, and that leaves Cabrelet by himself. The puck doesn't get through on net, but remember we talked in the first period about how Cabrelet is very good at making the sure the puck gets down, gets through, get into that traffic area. He did that there as he got into the skates of the massive humanity in front of the net. Pinballs around to Hagman for the goal.
Nicholas Hagman is the team's leading goal scorer. That's his 16th of the season. The Islanders lead cut to 2-1. Ian White put it into the corner. Colton Orr was spun around by Witt. White pinch, didn't get it. Joensuu slowed down ever so slightly by White. Beauchemin throws it off the boards and out to center. So the Maple Leafs on the board. With White off to Beauchemin, chased by Robbie Schrempp.
The third man high by Trent Hunter. See, that's a good third period read right there. He was waiting to get off the ice. He knew, though, he couldn't change just yet, so he went up high and read the play.
Now it's Kuhlman throwing one back intended for Kessel. It hit the stick of Witt. McDonald curls it around. A pinch by Schenn. He connects with Kuhlman. And the save by Rolison on a quick shot by Kessel.
Well, we can tell that the Maple Leafs are starting to build off that late second period rush that Butch talked about with assistant coach Gene Chenault, and they're moving the puck quicker as well. How a shorter pass, quicker pass.
Hagman 16th from Grabowski and Kapolei at 156. Has made it 2-1 Islanders. And now the Leafs look to come out. They do. It's Kessel on right wing. Leafs looking to change. Kessel working on Sutton, who gave him nothing. And McDonald plays it to the line. And it was chipped away from Kapolei by Thompson. And Komisarek back in the Toronto zone. Kapolei down the board. Kapolei pulls up. Wayne Primo under some pressure from Hillen. Now Komisarek leans ahead. Worked it to the corner. Primo cycled back for Ponikarovsky. Now to Kapolei looking for space. He shoots up high and a glove save. Rolison dropped it off. Sutton wound it around. Komisarek scrambling to keep it in. He just did.
Barely.
Now he chops one down low, but there's Big Sutton again. And Bailey heads up right wing into the Toronto zone. Bailey to Nielsen in front of Pozzo. He was tied up. Puck went behind him. Good play by Bailey to keep it alive. Gervais a shot. It's blocked by Komisarek, who is stickless. Komisarek doing what he can without the stick. Bailey hustles after it. Good shift by Josh Bailey here. Now Gervais fires one that's blocked. Ponikarovsky nudges it out of the zone. And Gervais fires it hard around. 15-14 to go in the third period. Komisarek with a long heave up right wing. Nobody home. But Rolison couldn't afford to gamble on the icing. And Hagman played it to the Islander line. Tavares has the decisive goal at this point of the game with the Islanders up 2-1. Now down the boards, Mikhail Grabowski, number 84 for Toronto. Taken in by McDonald. Grabowski back for Blake. Now White. Listed it down low. McDonald broke it up, then he gave it away to pesky Jason Blake.
Well, that's another thing that the Leafs are doing. They're wanting it so much more right now. They know they've got a period left to salvage something out of here after being down 2-0 ending into the third. And their sticks are all over the Islanders right now. The Islanders are chasing the play. The Leafs right now are dictating how they want the game to be played. The Islanders are getting it out after spending oodles of time in their own zone, Howie, and then having to regroup quickly, hopefully getting fresh guys on the ice.
Now Christmas Day on Christmas Day on MSG. Now Gervais fires it off the boards, and Hunter jams it deep. Hunter, Shrimp, Yoensu, the Islander line here. Leafs have their fourth line out. Mayers, Orr, and Vallin. A save by Gustafson. Hunter gets it back and lost it to Orr. And now Vallin offside. He slowed down, moved laterally, and everybody else kept going forward, including Jamal Mayers. 13:46 to go, third period on the island.
Need pain relief that won't mess with me.
Playing in his 20th game of the season, Jonas Gustafsson has put in a solid effort, and he's part of our New York Long Island Honda.com key players of the game. Our Honda key players are Henrik Lundqvist, Jaroslav Halak, Mike Smith, and tonight Jonas Gustafsson. The players at the position that Scott Gordon has talked about in the last few games, running into some hot goaltenders, and the Islanders have run into some hot goaltenders. They've, you know, had an opportunity at time to score some goals, and we know it's been tough for them to do, but Halak in particular, in my mind, Halak and Lundqvist were phenomenal. They were the, you know, of the four, they were the two best goaltenders. But on the other hand as well, the Islanders know that, well, you can talk about the goaltending, but you also have to make your own breaks too.
Rolison found a less than normal carom coming his way. So he was a little uneasy as he played that puck, and then a shot from the blue line by Komisarek gets through and is held by Rolison.
Time for the Islanders now to really, I mean, here's your obvious statement of the day. Stop playing in their own zone, Howie. It's just too much zone time to start the period. We're over 6 minutes, 6.5 minutes into this period, there's been very little offensive zone time for the Islanders here. Scott Gordon is going to keep imploring his team, guys, get the puck out, but don't do it after having to play 20 or 30 seconds in your own zone, because all you're going to do then is have to get off the ice and get fresh legs out there. Let's win the draws, let's get the puck in, let's initiate our forecheck and change the pace of the game, the style of play that's out there.
Richard Park trying to clear the zone, couldn't do it. Gervais has it back. Launches one off the board. Stepniak jumped on it, though. And it comes back out of the zone.
But it's plays like that right there that you've got to be stronger on the pass, stronger on the puck as well. Get it out. Make sure that they're not cheating in any facet of the game.
Monikarovsky centered, and Stepniak was there. He redirected it wide. Thompson moving the other way, locked up from behind by Wayne Primeau. Leafs have now outshot the Islanders 20-18. As they continue to have the better of play here in the third period. Dumped in by Primeau. Gervais rams it around the boards. Leafs have outshot the Islanders 7-2 here in the third. Stajan ragging it a bit with his teammates changing. Olsen got a stick on that pass across. But Kuhlman with a wraparound stopped by Rollison. Kuhlman was able to find the room to come around unimpeded, and Rollison did a good job, and Stajan got knocked down to all fours.
Yeah, he got
that
a
is
little,
Matt Stajan.
He got hit by Brendan Witt. And if Carey Fraser gonna, I don't know if he's gonna call a penalty or not.
I think he is. I think he's calling Witt.
I think he's gonna get Brendan Witt for a cross check or a slash. He's calling him for a cross check. The end of the play, after Kuhlman got to the front, Brendan Witt's gonna turn and he's gonna cross check Stajan in the side right there after the whistle. And the team that has been struggling to get the puck out of their own zone right now is going to find themselves shorthanded here in the third period.
The Islanders have only had one penalty kill so far in this game. And Scott Gordon complaining about something, but I think the video is going to bear Carey Fraser and his call to be true.
Well, there's something else that happened. Remember the old saying, I mean, you hear this from your young hockey player, they always catch the retaliation, you know. I don't think anything else happened. I think maybe Scott was talking about how they've done some stuff with their sticks before, but we'll see.
The Leafs win the draw. Stepniak. Beauchemin with a drive and a save by Rollison.
Kuhlman was moved out of the front by Jack Hillen. Wayne Rollison working hard to find the puck as well. As you know, they're going to obviously try and get traffic in front of him. He's just going to monitor the play. Oh, that's what the Islanders bench was up in arms about, was Kuhlman getting right into him there. I was watching the point play up top there, and then Rollison pops right up and makes a nice save. That could have been called. That should have been called a goaltender interference.
Now the draw deep in the Islander zone. Kessel. Back towards Beauchemin. Wrist shot. Tip. Rollison's got it. All right. Dwayne Rollison's having to fight a lot of holiday traffic in front of his net.
In this third period.
Yep.
It's like the super highway right in front of him at rush hour right now. You got guys everywhere around him, including some of his own players, as he's got to not just battle through the legs of Kuhlman or Stepniak, but also remember, they're bringing Islander defensemen down there with him as well. And so he's got to manage a way to move back and forth, up and down to find it.
From the draw, Beauchemin lays it around the boards. It winds up in the corner on Stepniak's stick. Beauchemin fires. That was blocked by Thompson, and the Islanders clear. Now Beauchemin, watched by Oposo. Oposo is up front with Nielsen here. Stride and Gervais on defense. Kessel. Trying to feed the blue line. He just did get it to Beauchemin through Oposo. But now Oposo pounces on it and brings it to center. Oposo driving to the net. Strong on Beauchemin. And a stop made by Gustafsson. And then Nielsen with a whack at it. But it wound up in the corner. And Hagman starts back now as he has to cut away from Nielsen, who's headed off. 47 seconds left to the Toronto power play. Good shift by Oposo on the penalty kill. Back in, Grabowski. And Sutton might have gotten a piece of that as it went wide.
He's another player that hasn't met a shot he didn't like, no matter where it was coming from. He is not afraid to shoot any spot on the ice, Grabowski.
Grabowski hands off to White. 26 seconds left to the penalty. On Brendan Witt, 10:39 remaining. Third period, 2-1 Islanders. McDonald up high and around, and a good play for now by White. However, it's grabbed back by Park for Comeau. Blake Comeau curling back, killing the penalty. Nicely to Park. That'll keep it deep for a few seconds and pretty much end the power play for Toronto. Two shots for the Leafs. And here comes Witt. Just in time to get a little piece of Blake as he dumps it in. Now Blake to Grabowski. Tied up by Gervais. He didn't clear. White kept it alive. And Sutton broke it up. And that sent all the way down. And this one's got enough oomph for an icing. And they'll bring it back into the Islander zone.
Strong play from Kyle Oposo earlier as we're back to even strength. Brendan went out of the penalty box. As you're going to see Oposo working in tandem up top. And here's a play that actually Beauchemin thought that Kessel was going to be at the point. He let that go through his legs. But Franz Nielsen working in tandem with Oposo helped create that opportunity. Now there's three D-men on the ice because remember, Witt just came out of the penalty box, Howie. So he's out there. Bruno Gervais is actually in the role of a right wing right now.
Brendan Witt steers it around. Will it get out? No. And Oposo has it again. Witt chases the dump in. 9.5 remaining in the third. Weak pass by Schrempf.
That's got to get in again. Those are the kind of plays where we talked opening up the third period. If you think you can make it, okay. But if you can't, get the red line, get the blue, get it in the zone. Don't make those plays. And now you're going to take another icing, and so you're going to have guys have to stay out on the ice. And it's been a long shift for a guy. In fact, like you remember, Brendan Witt came out many, you know, right out of the penalty box, and he's been out there the whole time.
Well, be out a little longer, and we'll be on a little longer after the buzzer, too, with our post-game coverage. You'll hear from Scott Gordon, get player reaction, and go around the league. The Jaguar Islanders post-game is next, but still 9:08 remaining in the third period here. 2-1 Islanders. Kessel put it off the skate of Jesse Owensu, and that's hammered all the way down by Schrempf, and that's going to keep those guys out there.
And you know, Scott Gordon knows. He knows it, but the next whistle, there's a TV timeout. He understands that. So I think most of these guys are okay now, too. You've had a little lull. You've had your 20 seconds, 18, 20 seconds in between faceoff, first one. These guys don't seem to be huffing and puffing, but what I'm sure Scott Gordon thought about calling a timeout.
Stajan won the draw cleanly. Kessel got the shot off, but it hit an Islander. And Kessel holds up Uensu in center. Brendan Witt came out of the box a minute and 19 playing seconds ago.
Well, now
he can change and the other guys can't.
Now this works out for the Islanders' benefit here. Now Scott Gordon has the benefit of putting out what he wants in the matchup as they get an offensive zone faceoff. Man, oh man, playing with fire. They're playing with fire, the Isles, in this period. They're back in their own zone and way too much.
10-2 Toronto in shots. We're in the third period. Kyle Oposo. Shot one off of Beauchemin. And Sutton fires it back in. Sutton, by the way, in a change of scoring, was credited with the second assist on the Tavares goal. They took that away from Hillen, so it's Tavares from Comeau. And Sutton at 12:17 in the second period.
Boy, has he been all over Phil Kessel in this game.
Now Bailey. Hard dump in, and the Islanders change on the move. 7:52 to go in the third period. Shen outlets. Here comes Hagman.
The penalty
coming up to the Leafs, an interference penalty. Just as they were on a rush into the Islanders' zone. 7:43 left of the third.
Billy, you're exactly right about the chip-ins for the New York Islanders. You can't have turnovers when you're leading 2-1. You need to be able to forecheck. And the reason the Islanders are in trouble these days is because they're turning the puck over, and the Toronto Maple Leafs are now coming up the ice with speed.
And that's got to drive a head coach like Scott Gordon in this instance crazy, because he's telling his guys, I guarantee you, Butch, I know you've told the guys this when you're behind the bench, and I know you're telling to yourself right now when you're watching it. Guys, get the puck in at all costs. Do not think you can make something out of nothing. It is not worth it this time of the game.
Well, exactly right. Even though they're on the power play, they've got to continue to work hard, make the smart plays.
So one for their last 26, but a huge opportunity here with a 2-1 lead. Blake off for interference at 12:17. The Islanders 0-for-2 with 3 power play shots. Tavares circles the net. sets up stride at the point. Oposo, one-timer, and that clipped the side of the net. And it's played off the glass, but not out. Kept in by Oposo. Finger failed to clear. So Schrempf moves it back. White got a piece of that pass to Oposo. Now he gets it to Schrempf. Or at least to Tavares, who was the intended receiver. Now Tavares gets it again. Tavares turns, shoots, blocked by Gustafson. Rebound missed by Molson. Schrempf again. Closes in. Feeds the blue line. Strike, the only one back, and he fumbles the puck, forcing the Islanders out of the zone, costing them some time. And a little more there as it's poked away by Primo.
That could be end of game ice right there.
Now Molson darting towards the net for Schrempf, and a kick save, Gustafson. And the Leafs clear as Stepniak fires it down. 40 seconds remaining on the penalty to Jason Blake of the Maple Leafs. 6:20 to go, third period. 2-1 Islanders. Bailey and Shen give chase. Stajan bumps Hunter. Hunter stays strong on the puck. Now for Hillen and Nielsen. Franz Nielsen moving up. Sets up Hillen. Hunter to the front of the net. Hillen's drive went wide.
Gustin didn't see that one when it got near him. He didn't. He just put his big body in the way, hoping it would hit him.
Stripe backing up. Five to the power play. Stripe to Hillen. Hunter's parked in front. Hillen throws it that way. It goes off the shoulder of Gustafson. Power play is over for the Maple Leafs. They had two shots. Nielsen into the corner. Bringing it wide was Bailey. 5:31 to go, third period. 2-1 Islanders. Stepniak checked by Hunter. And Beauchemin. As the Islanders need a change, Beauchemin has a clear path out. Now he's forced back by Thompson. Shen ahead for Kuhlman. He didn't hold it cleanly. Thought that Grabowski might have taken it in. Finally, it's put into the corner. Grabowski in to get it. Curls it around to the other side. Thompson beats Kessel to it. Two Leafs on Thompson. Grabowski, the second one, to force at least a temporary turnover. Sutton trying to even it out. They continue to battle along the boards with time ticking away. 4:48 remaining in the third. And it finally comes out. Kuhlman's got to jump back into his own zone. Put it off the stick of Park. Recovered by Cabrera, but he couldn't tee it up. And out Komisarek. Kessel. And Comeau for the Islanders, who's had a good game. Olsen forced to throw it back.
I think we're going to have
Islanders getting nailed with a penalty here. We'll see. Or is the net just off?
No, net's off. Net's off.
Howie Rose, Billy Jaffe, Deb Placey, Butch Goring with you at the Coliseum. Trent Hunter and John Tavares have the Islander goals. Here in the third period, Nick Hagman has scored for Toronto. It's 2-1 with 4:16 remaining in a third period that's been largely dominated by the Leafs.
Well, they came out knowing that they have, just like the Islanders, one period to go until a two-day Christmas break. And I guarantee you that Ron Wilson and his coaching staff went in there and gave it to their team, saying, look, it's been an unacceptable effort. The Islanders have outplayed you. You're still in the game. That was probably the thing he said. Look, you're lucky enough you're still in the game. But otherwise, go out there and show me something. And they've been working much harder as a team in general. We talked about in our open, especially since Phil Kessel's come back, they have been able to have a three-game over 500 record. They've gotten themselves back in the thick of things in the Eastern Conference, so much so in coming into this game. In fact, they had one more point than the Islanders, 34-33.
And for those who don't know, because Billy alluded to this a moment ago, as per the collective bargaining agreement, the entire National Hockey League shuts down on December 24th and December 25th. That was not always the case, although it's probably been, what, about 15 years or so since there was a game played on Christmas Eve or Christmas night in the National Hockey League. So the entire league will shut down for a couple of nights and give the players a chance to enjoy the holiday with their families. Ian White in the Toronto zone. Fires one ahead. Brought along now by Vallin, who elevates the pass to Hagman, but strike blocked Hagman's attempt at the net. And that's been so typical of what's gone on with the Islanders defensively in this game. Blocking a lot of shots and passes. Leafs have 23 shots that have gotten through, but a whole lot more have been blocked or simply missed the net. Now Blake brings it in. Jason Blake down the board. Vallin put it off Sutton's skate, but Blake gets it back. It's wound around to the blue line to White. Lofts it down low. 3:20 remaining in the third period. Blake put it out in front. And it ricochets back to Blake, and he's able to connect with White at the point, but he's trying to locate it. Now two Leafs in tight behind the net. That allows the Islanders' Jack Hillen to blast it around the boards. And this may be an icing.
I thought it was touched. I thought this was touched by finger along the wall, or I beg your pardon, by White. I think that this was touched. I think they missed this call, and Scott Gordon has a right to be upset about this one. Let's get a look at this. I believe that this should go to center ice. Let's take a look. Watch White. Yeah, he touches that. This should not be an icing. This should be at center ice. How he hit his right glove.
Well, doesn't look like anything's going to change. So the faceoff deep in the Islanders' zone, and the Leafs control. Kaberle walks the line. Now to Stepniak. He feeds it down low. This time the Islanders are able to clear, although Molson got turned around by Ponikarovsky. 2:42 remaining in the third period. Islanders up a goal. Stepniak in. Blocked again by Sutton, and it ricochets out in front. And Ponikarovsky just missed a wide open net. Centering feed. Oh, and Rolison denied Stepniak. The biggest save of the game for Rolison. For some goofy reason, the red light's on behind him. Rolison won't mind sunburns like that if he does what he just did. What a kick save.
First
Ponikarovsky totally.
That's the hockey god's way of saying, we missed the icing, we're going to have him miss the net there. But then that's just a great save by Rolly the goalie in net.
Bailey for Nielsen. 2 minutes to go in the third. It's not supposed to be easy. Bailey chips one under pressure. Gustafson covers, gets the whistle, and now some almost predictable pushing and shoving, but time very much the issue now for really both of these teams.
Absolutely. Dwayne Rolison staring at Ponikarovsky, who's just going to come down the gut. The puck is going to pinball to the front. There he is, and he pushes it wide. Perhaps handcuffs him a little bit, but then Stepniak releases from the blue paint to the top of it, and right there as he kicks it, watch the right or the left pad just flash down on the ice. Beautiful recovery by Dwayne Rolison, finding the puck right there. Josh Bailey able to get the puck and then take it out. The Islanders, is it the Islanders taking the timeout?
Well, the referee, Dean Morton, just pointed to the Islander bench, so I would assume so.
Yeah, okay. Well, I never assume anything.
I don't blame you. But this time the assumption is correct.
All right.
So he held his breath, got that, and here's some more breath holding for the Islanders.
That's a nice play by Stepniak, too, corralling it with the left skate, pushing it over to stick blade after puck protection by Ponikarovsky, but the beautiful save right there by Dwayne Rolison saves the day, literally, for Scott Gordon's Islanders squad. The Islanders have played an immense part of this period in their zone. The last few minutes have been a little bit better. They've been able to generate a little bit more out of their, I won't even call it offensive zone, but at least out of their own end zone time. But now, 1:52 remaining. Ron Wilson's squad is going to be pressing. They're going to be pressing an awful lot. Look for their D-men to activate and be involved in all plays in the offensive zone.
And for their goaltender to depart at some point, 1:52 remaining. We'll see exactly when Ron Wilson does that, pending the Leafs gaining control and getting it into the Islanders' zone. Sutton prevents that here. Andy Sutton has had a terrific game.
Yes, he has.
Josh Bailey moves into the Leafs' zone. Oposo heads to the net. Bailey wants to keep it deep. We talked about safe plays before. He made one there, but the Leafs get it back. Minute and a half to go. Gustafson goes to the bench. Leafs trying to change the goaltender. They don't have firm control of the puck. The net is empty. Oposo will take one in any manner, as it's been a long time.
Yeah, but he needs to get fresh guys on. They get off now. That's the most important thing.
Oposo's got 17 games without a goal. Leafs gain entry. Ponikarovsky from a deep angle misses. Minute 8 to go. White with a pass that Beauchemin scrambles to keep alive. And it's fired around the boards, but White keeps it in. Final minute, third period. Toronto net is empty. Islanders leading 2-1. Beauchemin couldn't hold the pass. Now Ponikarovsky lost it to Sutton, who frankly has been all over the place defensively for the Islanders. And Comeau now up for Thompson. Empty net ahead. Thompson to Comeau. He'll have a slam dunk. It goes wide,
but a
penalty will mean an automatic goal. The net was empty. And so in a situation where you might call a penalty shot with a goaltender, it's an automatic goal.
Yep.
And the Islanders will take a 3-1 lead. Not sure the crowd understands the rule here.
Enough of them do.
Because they haven't celebrated suitably.
There's enough that are cheering right now that understand it. And then there's going to be others that once Kerry Fraser announces it, here we go.
A goal has been awarded to number 57, foul from behind, no goal to
the net. Well, Blake Comeau literally scored a goal. He literally put himself in the net. The problem is the puck didn't go there, but because of his diligent effort, a nice play as well by Nate Thompson up top. The Islanders, it looks like, with 35 seconds remaining, will go into Christmas break with a victory over the Toronto Maple Leafs.
I'm not sure the guy who's charged with playing the goal song and sounding the siren knew the rule either. But maybe he was just being cautious,
cautious.
Not taking anything for granted. But as soon as the arm of Kerry Fraser went up, it was an automatic goal. And gee, people across Long Island can jam Wendy's for their free chili tomorrow. The Islanders have actually scored three goals.
Christmas Eve's like chili. Nothing.
Yeah, it gives a different sort of flavor to Christmas morning.
Yes, it does.
Honey. Well, after the game, our team will break down all the highlights, plus hear from Coach Gordon, get player reaction to go around the league. The Jaguar Islanders postgame is next. Comeau's third from Thompson at 19:25. And you have to go back to December the 3rd. Last time the Islanders scored three goals in regulation. That's one day shy of 3 weeks ago. So, Blake Comeau, I'll tell you what. He deserves this because he's had a whale of a game, too.
Yes, he has.
Made the play to set up Tavares' goal. We talked about an excellent defensive play, one in particular that he made in the second period. And you know, Blake Comeau needs games like this to assure the continued confidence of Scott Gordon. And a game like this goes a long way.
For the most part, the last few games, look, Blake Comeau has done his role. What is, for the most part, what's been asked of him. To get rewarded with that goal is that's just the nice icing on the top of the cake right there. He's had a good game. Sutton's had a good game. There's been some other very responsible players as well, but those two definitely have jumped out.
Carberlet was given a penalty at 19:37. I'm not even sure exactly what the call is. It doesn't matter. There are only 9 seconds to go. The Islanders have a win in their pockets. And Mark Streit is going to keep it right there as the horn sounds. And the Islanders end their four-game home losing streak. Remember that save Rolison made on Stempniak before Comeau got the empty netter, technically. And the Islanders have a 3-1 win over the Toronto Maple Leafs.
So important. So important because these next 2 days, you don't think about hockey an awful lot as a player because you want to just get that break. You can't come to the rink. You don't even want to come to the rink, obviously. But you know what? There's that thing inside of you that says, all right, you know what? We stemmed it. We stemmed the tide right now. We stopped the bleeding. We're going to be okay. We're coming back against our big rival, the Rangers, in a few days. So you know that they're going to be juiced up for that regardless. But they're going to go into that game, Howie, not feeling a heck of a lot better than they would have if they didn't find a way to win this one. And big, look, also winning in regulation is big, too, because even if you end up winning it in overtime or a shootout, you knew that you gave up a two-goal lead. Here, they held on to it. They found a way to hold on to it and keep it up.
So the Islanders with a 3-1 win. Dwayne Rolison, the last man off the ice, although he may factor into the three stars, which we'll show you. Blake Comeau played well. Andy Sutton was as good as any Islander tonight. Tavares had what proved to be the game winner. So a lot of choices here. And the first choice,
Hagman,
he scored the Toronto goal. All right. Rolison, the second star.
I
understand why they gave it to Hagman, I guess.
And the first star from the New York Islanders, number 91, John Tavares.
Well, John Tavares got what proved to be the game winner, and that's enough to make him the first star of the game. And that means that after providing a souvenir, they'll talk about it with Deb Kaufman, or Deb Placey, downstairs. Same deal, right, Deb?
Absolutely. You guys put in a lot of work to try to get back to scoring goals. It paid off tonight.
Yeah, it's nice to get the few that we got, but I think the defensive effort was outstanding, and Raleigh was great. Our PK was strong, and we did the things we needed to get a win.
How about the play that Blake Comeau made to get that pass to you from behind the goaltender?
Yeah, that was a great play. He had a quick 2-on-1 there. I thought he was going to shoot it for sure, but he made a nice move, and he really played well tonight and stepped up for us in a big way.
Will you enjoy your holiday more now with the win to go out?
Yeah, for sure. That's definitely what I asked for Christmas. So Merry Christmas to everybody as well. Have a happy holiday.
Thanks, congratulations. All right, happy holidays from John Tavares. He gave the Islander fans 2 points for Christmas.
And Debbie also gave his relatives and friends back in Toronto an opportunity to see him defeat his hometown team. 3-1 the final. Our post game begins after this.